So we're looking here is the Sphynx with its head. We're gonna go ahead and add some gold to it to liven it up a little bit. These moves, like this obelisk right here. So today we're gonna be taking some of this here 24 karat gold cadence, or untouchable decadence, and put it right here on our Sphynx, and we'll go from there. Let's see. Is what I think Sphynx look like. Before greed got a hold of the world, I think the whole world came together as one and they built the Sphynx. And then times got tight, and then slowly all the thieves came and started taking the outer layer of the Sphynx and sold that off, melted the gold, made whatever it is, sold, you know, different traces of it. Too bad time it is where it's at now, because it is older than the city Egypt. And the inhabitants. So here's what that looks like so far. We're trying to restore honor, balance, and respect. I won't be over here painting this and talking bad about anything. But, like, this is my own funds, my own resources, my thoughts. So, a lot of people, looks like the head of the Sphynx is a lion, but it's actually the head of the first ruler, which might have brought technology that was advanced, being how he could have been time traveling extraterrestrial. And they look just like us. Only difference is their genealogy might be a little different. They might have four testicles and four holes in their head, which means they come from a different environment than us. Which means they have those for a reason. Which, you know, they could elaborate and explain much more than we can just sit back and wonder. But I think this was one of the places where they had visited prior to going to India and such. Let me hear your thoughts. What do you think? You think I'm right? You think maybe there was a deity that, or, you know, that was more than a man that could have been made in a test tube, per se, that ended up not only gaining the freedom of the world on his or her own, but united all everybody as one? Could have been an intergalactic battle that took place, you know? With history always being constantly rewritten, who's to say what was really truth? Because they wanted the workers to be literate and only wanted them to follow what they wanted them to believe back in the time. So a lot of truth was what they wanted to write. Like, I bet if we were to look at old slave Bible, it'd have a different kind of Bible text in there than it would in the Bible in general, and therefore you can tell the difference and know the difference of, you know, how they had felt towards other people, feeling like nobody had the equal rights as them. And the truth is, like each of every other plant, animal, they all serve a purpose that helps the world function. And some of those ancient technologies got lost due to greed along the way. There you can kind of make out the nose structure. So you can kind of see it. Oh my, what a beaut. We'll see what mysteries are unveiled once we fully out this rendering of the Sphynx.
Thank you. And that's it for right now. I gotta take it outside and look cool.